We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India.
Good afternoon all. I am Dr. Chintan Jodhania from Shankar Sri Vaghela Bapu Institute of Technology. We will discuss today environmental science module number 4, a topic called as basic concepts of smart city. So important unit, few questions will be there in your final exam of GTU. So we will learn the concept of smart city in this module. So what actually smart city is? So first we will learn about the smart city. So smart cities are nothing but those urban areas which have smart, we can say intelligent, physical, social, institutional and economic infrastructures. So all cities may not be smart cities, but they can by developing these 4 important pillars which are there for making a smart city: physical, social, institutional as well as economic infrastructure. So based on these 4 pillars, the smart city definition is focused. So it is an urban area in which all these 4 parameters are mainly focused on it, and the heart of the smart city is always a citizens which are living at that city. So it is different from different authors. There is no universal definition of smart city, but it is mainly focused on these 4 parameters: physical, social, institutional as well as economic infrastructure. So it is a well developed. Information and communication technologies are so strong in smart city. So this is certain idea you will be have about smart city. It is not an ordinary city. It is a city with highly technology advanced city in which the life standard is somewhat high. So that is a concept of smart city. How actually it is looking like? So it will be look like this. A smart city will be looking like this. Sometimes you can also say you can have it is just extraordinary city view we are having. So it is having well balanced infrastructures, use of the energy, all things. So it is well developed city. So that will be some ideas you might be having in your mind. This is what we can say about smart city. What are the main characteristics of smart city we are having? So whenever we want a smart city, it always uses its physical infrastructure more efficiently, and generally strong and healthy economic, social and cultural development should be there. It always reduces the usage of environmental capital and supports smart growth. It also promotes the use of information and communication technologies, and the lifestyle means quality of the life is very high in smart city. So these few characteristics of smart city we can have. So these characteristics is important to become a smart city. What are the factors required to become a smart city? So there are a lot of factors. It provides holistic urban environment. It should provide an opportunity for new generation to participate in cities management. It should provide satisfactory lifestyles to people. It is living standard is somewhat high. Technology is well governed in the city, and it is highly manageable. the technology, town city, efficient city. It should have smart grids of infrastructure, transport and energy. And the quality of water supply, sanitization, electrical supply, healthcare, it is somewhat high, communication networks, cleanliness, solid waste management, and better public transport as well as safety. These are all required factors for becoming a smart city. So to make a smart city, we have to take care about all these parameters. Then and then only a city can become a smart city. How much investment we need? Approximately 80,000 to 90,000 crore investment is needed to build a smart city, and it requires, means it occupies a large land area, about 800 to 1500 acres of land that is required to build a smart city. So highly cost needed to develop a smart city, as well as large land also mandatory for making a smart city. So investment as well as land, both are extremely large amount we are needed. I have mentioned here few top 10 smart cities in the world. It may vary, but you can read the name: Manila, Toronto, Paris, New York, London, Tokyo, Berlin, Hong Kong, Barcelona. They are the smart cities. They are just different from other cities. Lifestyle, technology, transportation, health, standard of living standards are extremely high. So that's why they become a smart city. So smart city is also the people life standard is too high. That is why the job opportunities as well as the it is playing a main role for the growth of the country. So due to these idea in mind, India is also developing a smart city. It is also having a mission of smart city. So we can have the development of smart cities in India. So the National Smart City Mission is an urban renewable program by Government of India with the mission to develop smart cities across the country. 100 Smart City Mission was launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on 25th of June 2015. So this dream is of our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and he has announced the smart city concept on 25th of June 2015. So government has also given fund a total of 98,000 crore rupees, or you can say a $40 billion was approved by the Indian cabinet for the development of 100 smart cities and the rejuvenation of the 500 other cities. And in which 98,000 crore rupees are bifurcated in two ways. First, 48,000 crore rupees, around $6.7 billion, is used to build a new smart cities, and other 50,000 crore rupees are used in Atal mission for reformation, or you can say rejuvenation and urban transformation project. Means whatever the cities we are having, that we are now converting into the smart city. So in that mission, around 50,000 crore rupees has been invested. So altogether, the budget for these 100 smart city was announced on 25th of June 2015, and that is approximately 98,000 crore rupees. So this is the picture where you can see the Prime Minister Narendra Modi at the launch ceremony of Smart City Mission, Pune, June 2016. Country India, Prime Minister Modi, Ministry of Urban and Development. Key people, it is a vision of Narendra Modi. It is, has been launched on 2015. The funding is around 98,000 crore rupees, approximately $40 billion. We are having official website of this smart city, government website of smart cities. You can click on this website or you can Google it, smartcities.government.in. So you can have the idea regarding the smart city mission of India. So when you click or you can just Google it, you will be having this homepage. This is the official website homepage of smart city mission. As you can see here, Surat is one of the smart city of Gujarat. So when this is the official web page, home page. So when you click on, lot of informations we are having regarding the smart cities. What are the features are there? How many cities are there? What are the planning of each cities? How we are developing the cities? Lot of informations are there in the in this official website. So you can just have a look about this website. So according to this project, the first 20 cities has been announced. 20 cities has been selected in phase one. And after that, 2-3 more phases are announced. And in that total, all over India, 100 cities has been selected for smart city project. And in them, in Gujarat, we are having 6 cities who has been selected for smart city project. So in Gujarat, we are having total 6 cities. And these smart cities list I have highlighted here. One of the cities, Gandhinagar, Surat, Baroda, Rajkot, Ahmedabad, Dahod. So these are the 6 cities right now which has been selected from Gujarat to make these cities as a smart city. So this is the list of 6 smart cities of Gujarat. The first list which was published, in that 20 smart cities across India have been selected. And these cities I have highlighted here. You can see here in first list, only 2 city of Gujarat has been selected, and that is Ahmedabad and Surat. But after that, second and third and fourth list has been published, and in that we have about 6 cities has been selected from Gujarat to convert that city into the smart city. So this is a list of first 20 cities which are selected for smart city. It is having different states. Now the important concept of the basic pillars of a smart cities, or what are the requirements we are having for smart city. So whenever we are trying to build a smart city, we are always focusing on main 4 pillars. And that 4 pillars are institutional infrastructure, physical infrastructure, social infrastructure, and economic infrastructure. So based on these 4 pillars, the smart city have been focused. And the main focus in the smart city concept is the citizen of that city. So it is altogether moving around the citizen of that, or the peoples which are living in that city. So it always creates some employment, quality of the lifestyle is somewhat high. It is always having a skilled persons. It is highly invested city. Investment is too high. So based on these 4 parameters, 4 pillars, smart cities have been focused. So we will discuss one by one, so we can have the idea regarding four pillars. And it is asked in final exam of GTU. So describe the basic four pillars of smart city. So smart city is always focused on these four pillars. First is the institutional infrastructure. Second one is the physical infrastructure. Third one is social infrastructure. And the last one is the economic infrastructure. So we will discuss one by one. First, we will go for institutional infrastructure. What actually we should think of in institutional infrastructure? As the name suggests, institutional means we are always focused in this pillar on governance of the city. Whatever the offices or the communications, the government, we are having government people with the citizens or peoples, it should be highly strong. High quality governance should be there. Especially the e-governance is more focused on it. And all citizens must be participated in e-governance. So that is the first pillar. The governance should be extremely high quality. And it always try to be e-governance. Management system and planning is extremely high. It is very well defined, and that includes all these parameters: PD service delivery, security, taxation, institutional finance and banking, transparency and accountability, skill development, environmental susceptibility, people's participations in decisions, citizen advisory committee. So these all parameters include the smart governance. So institutional infrastructure is most important. So first pillar, which is focused on governance, and it is highly recommended that it is a e-governance. The bonding between government people as well as citizen is so strong that there is no gap between these two. So first, we are more focusing on smart governance. So first is the institutional infrastructure in which we are focusing on governance of the city. Second in, as the name suggests, physical infrastructure. Means physical means the buildings and the developing physical infrastructures which we are having so in the city. So it includes residential as well as commercial buildings, transportation systems, energy systems, water supply, sewage systems, sanitization facility, solid waste management systems, and lot more. So these facilities are integrated using the technology, and it covers all these parameters: power supply, water supply, solid waste management, sewage management, multimodal transport facilities, citywide fiber connections, connectivity by road, by airport, as well as by railways. Housing and disaster management is also strong. So whenever we talk about physical infrastructure, so we are always focused on the building and the development of the infrastructures which is available in the city. It includes all these four parameters, all others factors which I have highlighted here. So second is focused on physical infrastructures. Third one, which is the social infrastructure, and it involves the working for the redevelopment of the human and social capitals. The lifestyle is somewhat high, but there should not be gap between the communities, society. So for that, education as well as healthcare as well as entertainment sectors are more focused in social infrastructures. So education facilities extremely good healthcare facilities at the highest level, and for entertainment purpose, we should have to build park, music centers, cinemas, sports centers, gym, all that things should be there. We should also have planning of backward categories people for their development, like SC, ST or some other backward categories. So poor peoples, we should have buildings for the poor peoples. So social infrastructure is always gives bonding between the peoples of that city. And that is by education, healthcare and entertainment. So that is a third pillar, which is more focused on the human and social capital. That is a social infrastructure. Fourth one is the economic infrastructure. This is the important one. How we can attract, or how that city is going to attract the investment from other cities or other countries also. So it is also important pillar of the smart city. It have some industries or it have some jobs. It creates some jobs. The market growth means the production industries. It contributes to the GDP. So that are some important parameters in fourth pillar. So it always attracts investments and it creates the appropriate economic infrastructure for the employment opportunity. So it always contributes in GDP. It always creates some jobs, livelihoods, activities and market growth. These are the parameters for economic infrastructure. So based on these four, all are in different category. Institutional, it is more focused on governance. Physical, it focuses on the physical infrastructure present in the city. Social, it gives the bonding between humans and social capital. Economic, it contributes to the GDP and growth and employment and job creation. So all four parameters or four pillars are extremely important to have a smart city. So that is the most important question. Four basic pillars of smart city. So we are having a four basic pillar of the smart city. So that is a good question you should prepare. And last one, what is the features of smart city? So all together, we have in smart city, smart governance, smart education, smart healthcare, smart building, smart mobility, smart infrastructure, smart technology, smart energy, smart citizens. So all together, they combine and become build a smart city. So these are the main few important things we should take care or we should take care if we want to build a smart city. Thank you. Thank you all.